Hello everyone. Today I will be talking about Azure NetApp Files supported network topologies. Specifically, connectivity to an Azure NetApp Files volume and a peered VNet within the same region. Consider this. A prompt engineer needs to access files on volume 2. The volume is in a delegated subnet within VNet 2. The engineer wants to access volume 2 from VM 1. The virtual machine is in a default subnet within VNet 1. It was noticed that VNet 1 and VNet 2 are in the same region. So the engineer attempted to connect to volume 2 from VM 1. After many attempts to access volume 2 from VM 1, it did not work. Next, the engineer consults the team lead for solutions. The team lead informs the engineer that they must set up VNet peering between VNet 1 and VNet 2. This is known as a VNet peering topology. VNet peering within the same region is a supported network topology for Azure NetApp Files volume creations and connectivity. Once peering is configured properly, the engineer can access volume 2 in VNet 2 from VM 1 in VNet 1. Let's validate if the team lead solution will work. From the diagram, you can see VM 1 is in VNet 1. And to the right of the diagram, you can see volume 2 is in VNet 2. Though both virtual networks are in the same region, they cannot access each other's resources, being that there is no peering between the two virtual networks. I will attempt to connect to volume 2 from VM 1 with no VNet peering. Let's move on to next steps. Now, I am here on my system. We know that there is no VNet peering between VNet 1 and VNet 2. Being that VM 1 is in VNet 1 and wants to access volume 2, which is in VNet 2, the mount command should fail. Let's put that into practice. I will verify that my volume 2 directory is present by running a list all in the parent directory of volume 2. Volume 2 directory is there. Now, I will paste and run the mount command. The mount commands hangs. As expected, we were not able to connect to volume 2 from VM 1. Now, let's put the team lead solution into practice. First, we will dive into creating a VNet peering between VNet 1 and VNet 2. Now, I am here in the Azure portal. Under the Azure NetApp Files Volume Overview blade for Volume 2. In the main window, notice the virtual network /subnet section here. Volume 2 has a delegated subnet in VNet 2. Click the link here and it will redirect you to VNet 2's overview page. Remember, the prompt engineer wants to connect to Volume 2 from VM 1, and because Volume 2 and VM 1 are in different virtual networks, configuring a peering between VNet 1 and VNet 2 is the best solution for connectivity to Volume 2 from VM 1. Now, let's move on to creating our VNet peering. Notice the left-hand pane. Scroll down until you see the settings drop-down. If it isn't expanded, go ahead and expand the settings drop-down here. Once settings is expanded, scroll down until you see peerings and select it. Notice there is no peerings. So, no connectivity to volume 2 from VM 1 is expected behavior. We can now establish a peering connection between VNet 1 and VNet 2. I will start by clicking Add here in the main window. This will redirect the page to the peering creation window. First, under the Remote Virtual Network Summary section, I will fill out a peering link name. It is important to understand that the name of the peering from the local virtual network. The name must be unique within the virtual network. Next, virtual network deployment model. Select which deployment model the virtual network you want to peer with was deployed through. I will leave it set to default value. Next steps, if you have read access to the virtual network you want to peer with, leave this checkbox unchecked. If you don't have read access to the virtual network or subscription you want to peer with, select this checkbox. I will check I know my resource ID and paste in VNet 1's resource ID. Let's move forward. For remote virtual network peering settings. First, allow VNet 1 to access VNet 2 by default. This option is selected. I will leave this option selected. Select this option to allow traffic from VNet 1 to VNet 2. This setting enables, e.g., communication between hub and spoke and hub-spoke network topology and allows a VM in VNet 1 to communicate with a volume in VNet 2. Next, allow VNet 1 to receive forwarded traffic from VNet 2. Enabling this option will allow VNet 1 to receive traffic from virtual networks peered to VNet 2. For example, if VNet 2 has an NVA that receives traffic from outside of VNet 2 that gets forwards to VNet 1, you can select this setting to allow that traffic to reach VNet 1 from VNet 2. While enabling this capability allows the forwarded traffic through the peering, it doesn't create any user-defined routes or network virtual appliances. User-defined routes and network virtual appliances are created separately. Next, allow gateway or route server in VNet 1 to forward traffic to VNET 2. Enabling this setting will allow VNET 2 to receive traffic from VNET 1's gateway or route server. In order for this option to be enabled, VNET 1 must contain a gateway or route server. I will not use this option. Next. Enable VNET 1 to use VNET 2's remote gateway or route server. This option can be enabled only if VNET 2 has a remote gateway or route server and VNET 2 enables allow gateway in VNET 2 to forward traffic to VNET 1. This option can be enabled in only one of VNET 1's peerings. Now, we must fill out the details for local virtual network summary. For the peering link name, I will enter the details here. Next, I will only check allow VNET 2 to access VNET 1. I will leave the rest unchecked. Lastly, I will click Add and wait for the request to complete. Remember, VNET peering within the same region is a supported network topology for Azure NetApp Files volume creations and connectivity. Once the request completes, you will notice that the peering sync status shows fully synchronized and peering state shows connected. We can now connect to Volume 2 from VM1. Here, you will see a snapshot of Volume 2's mount instructions portal blade. I will use these mount instructions to mount Volume 2 on VM1. I will not install the NFS client in this demonstration, but if you need to install the NFS client, follow the steps above to install. Now, let's move on to attempting to connect to Volume 2 from VM1 using the mount instructions. Now, let's mount Volume 2 here on VM1. First, I will create a Volume 2 directory. Then run a list all command to verify the directory is there. Okay, we have verified the Volume 2 directory is present. Now, I will run the mount command. The command ran with no errors. Let's verify it is mounted by running df-h. As you can see, the volume is mounted. I will change directories into the Volume 2 directory. I will run a list all command to verify I can read on Volume 2, that is now verified. Lastly, I will write a file called peering.txt to verify I can write on the volume. We have now verified that we can write to the volume. The team lead solution worked and the engineer can now access files on Volume 2 from VM1 using a VNet peering within the same region. For more information on Azure NetApp Files supported network features, see the links in the description.